We lost Quincy, too.
Did he give a reason?
Yeah, he thinks your numbers aren't likely to rebound.
We're three votes down again, sir. Mr. President, as of this morning, Sydney only needed one more vote. Now, the Motown Three have got to be scared blind. I don't think there'll be a better opportunity.
The press is expecting an announcement on the crime bill by the State of the Union.
And if you agree to stick 455 in a drawer till after the elections, they'll give you the three votes.
And we declare victory, sir.
We said as a last resort.
We're there, sir. State of the Union is 48 hours away.
Oh, come on, Leon. There's got to be three votes someplace.
There isn't.
Bullshit! There's got to be somebody
there
out there.
There isn't, sir.
Storch.
I beg your pardon?
What about Storch?
No, Storch is a no.
Mr. President.
Wagner.
No.
Sobel.
Nope.
Clark.
No.
Not that Clark, the one from Indiana.
That one too, sir.
Mr. President, I think we have to do this.
AJ, she is one vote away. It's important legislation that for the first time has a legitimate chance. She deserves every opportunity.
You meant it, didn't you, sir? You meant the important legislation deserves every opportunity.
Lewis, shut up.
You have something to say to me, Lewis?
Respectfully, sir, I think we should examine the new poll for something more than its
value. Examine what? They don't like that I'm going out with Sydney.
It's not that simple. I think that this poll brings a murky problem and a specific relief.
Whose problem are we talking about, Lewis? Yours? You worried about losing your job? Because this poll isn't talking about my presidency. This poll is talking about my life. 264 million people
don't give a damn about your life. They give a damn about their own.
All right, that's enough.
Mr. President, you raised a daughter almost entirely on your own. And she's terrific. So what does it say to you that in the past 7 weeks, 59% of this country has begun to question your family values?
The president doesn't answer to you, Lewis.
Oh, yes, he does, AJ. I'm a citizen. This is my president. And in this country, it is not only permissible to question our leaders, it's our responsibility. But you already know that, don't you, Mr. President? Because you have a deeper love of this country than any man I've ever known. And I want to know what it says to you that in the past 7 weeks, 59% of Americans have begun to question your patriotism.
Look, if people want to listen to
me, they don't have a choice. Bob Rumson is the only one doing the talking. People want leadership, Mr. President. In the absence of genuine leadership, they'll listen to anyone who steps up to the microphone. They want leadership. They're so thirsty for it, they'll crawl through the desert toward a mirage, and when they discover there's no water, they'll drink the sand.
Lewis, we have had presidents who were beloved, who couldn't find a coherent sentence with two hands and a flashlight. People don't drink the sand because they're thirsty. They drink the sand because they don't know the difference.
Mr. President, what do you want to do about 455?
Make the deal.
Yes, sir.